We don't have the capability in the moment or at the bedside to know that a particular patient has the Delta variant. So we know that the state does some monitoring of that. We also are working on being part of a collaborative that's going to do more of that sequencing going forward. We know the CDC on a national level does sequencing on that. And what we do know is that roughly 25% of the COVID cases in the United States currently are the Delta variant. And we've said over the last few weeks, about every 2 weeks, that number is doubling. So we expect that number to increase. So invariably, the cases we see locally, even if we don't know it right then in the moment, will be Delta variant, and we're expecting that. You know, the importance of vaccination, and because we know that vaccinations are safe and effective, and they prevent people from getting COVID, and even in the Delta variant. So we get that question a lot is, hey, what about vaccines and Delta variant? The vaccines are effective for the Delta variant. So while we're concerned about Delta variants, the same things that we've talked about from the beginning of the pandemic, masking, social distancing, getting vaccinated, are still really effective. And I think if you're in a situation where you're gonna be in close contact with folks and you can't be totally isolated with those people, there's a chance if someone comes in there with COVID, it's gonna spread, whether it's a sports team or a place of business or a hospital or any of those kind of places. So vaccination is the key there and the way to prevent those things from happening. What we know about Delta variant is that it's more transmittable. The way it interacts with human cells is more efficient, and it may be more likely to evade the immune system in the unvaccinated. And so I think that could lead to more serious cases and ultimately more hospitalizations, which could come after a big holiday weekend where there's a spread in some communities. Most part right now, the vaccines seem to be effective. If you're talking about mRNA vaccines, you need to get both doses. I know there've been times during the pandemic where we said, oh, maybe one dose is enough. Some countries took that approach. Some national experts really asked and suggested that, you know, one dose is enough. Give everybody one dose before you do the two doses. We're past that stage. There's plenty of vaccine now. And we know that two doses in the mRNA vaccine are necessary. So if you're someone who's only gotten one dose, you need to go get that second dose if you want to have maximum protection against the Delta variant. There may be some variability in protection between vaccine products. It's a little hard to tease out. But even the vaccine products that maybe have a little less protection still have quite a bit of protection and are worth getting.